would like to welcome you to my presentation today. I will talk about TASTE, which is a tariff analytical and simulation tool for economists. This tool was developed many years ago by Mark Horridge and David Laborde. And today I'm presenting data updates and applications of this program. The work I'm presenting today was done by Mark Horridge and Dean Mustakinov and myself. Why do we need additional programs to aggregate tariffs? At the HS6 digit tariff line level of the harmonized system, we have 219 million data. For example, for butter with a fat content not exceeding 85%, we have a tariff line which is called 040510. And for this specific tariff line, we have a specific tariff. So, and on the model level, we have product aggregates like agricultural primary products, agricultural processed products, other primary sectors or manufacturers, which are aggregated to the model level. So while at the detailed tariff line level, 219 million data exists, trade policies are implemented at the tariff line level, which is the HS6 level with 6 digits, but we have even more detailed tariff line schedules, which are organized at the 8-digit, 10-digit, or even 12-digit level. The models like GTAP run at a more aggregated level. To aggregate the tariff data from the detailed tariff line level and from the level of trade policies to the model level, we need additional tools. Therefore, I'm presenting TASTE today. So I will look back into the history of TASTE and then come to some future things. I will show which kind of updates of TASTE have already taken place. I will show some applications, some limitations, and ideas for future developments. To analyze the impact of the proposals of the WTO, researchers had to deal with bound and applied tariff rates and with tiered tariff reduction formulas. So, between bound and applied tariff rates, there was a difference. The bound tariff rates was a tariff which was negotiated in the WTO negotiations, and the applied tariff was a bilateral tariff which is actually applied between two countries. The tiered tariff reduction formula implies that high tariffs are cut more than low tariffs. So to address both of these issues, there was a need to make the tariff cuts in the database, or not at the model level. Additionally, in the database, we had 8 to 11 gigabytes of data, and these data at that time were not harmonized, so they need to convert it into ad valorem equivalence. They were in the initial tables, they are in, for example, in tons or in kilogram or in percentage of alcohol, and everything needs to be converted into percentage tariff rates to make them comparable. And these tariff data are also too large to load them into Excel or into a text editor, so additional programs are needed. A lot of institutions build their own programs to process the data. And one run of these additional programs took several hours. We analyzed the WTO negotiations with the help of the statistical software SAS. We built a tariff database at the HS6 digit tariff line level and aggregated this tariff database to the model level of the GTAP model. So we got new base data at the model level. And then we implemented the WTO scenarios, starting in the database at the HS6 digit tariff line level, implemented tariff cuts, and aggregated the reduced tariff rates to the model level. Then we compared the base data at the model level with the reduced tariff rates at the model level compared them, and implemented a shock into the GTAP model. The tool TASTE, which is easy to use, fast and flexible. It is easy to use because it lowers the entry barriers to run tariff scenarios, and the format of tariff changes can be directly used by the GTAP model. And it includes predefined formulas. It is extremely fast compared to our SAS tools. It takes at maximum 5 minutes to apply tariff rules for 200 million data. And it is flexible. There are two methods of tariff aggregation. So to aggregate the tariffs, we can use trade-weighted or reference group-weighted aggregation methods. And we can consider bound and applied tariff rates. And for the applied tariff rates, there are most favored nation rates and preferential rates included. Database is based on the MacMaps ITC tariff data, protection data. And this TASTE tool is consistent with the tariff data which are included into the standard GTAP model. And TASTE allows additional uses of these protection data. So for example, the data can be viewed or extracted in more detail with the TASTE program. It is also possible to implement sector splits, and it is possible to build more detailed models where trade is modeled at a 6-digit level or at a 4-digit level, and to include new GTAP sectors. So TASTE has been initially used to analyze the impacts of the WTO negotiations, but now TASTE is mainly used for regional trade agreements. So we can find studies about TPP, about the CETA, the Canada-EU trade agreement, about TTIP, the African ACP agreement, the Japan-EU agreement, or the ECOWAS agreement. And we can also find studies about cumulative effects of free trade agreements. TASTE has been used for studies on the EU enlargement with Croatia. It has been used for Brexit scenarios and also for the implications of trade wars. And there are also some applications where partial and general equilibrium models are linked. And it has been used for sector splits. To use a TASTE, it is necessary to update the data regularly. TASTE has been updated several times. The last version was done for GTAP 10 database with the base year 2014. The data source of this version is the MacMaps ITC database, and it includes applied tariff rates, preferential as well as MFN rates, and bound tariff rates. It is based on 219 million records, and that's why the software has been changed from a 32-bit version to a 64-bit version, because it was not possible with the old TASTE to process this high amount of data. In total, we have 4,205 HS categories, which can be aggregated to 65 GTAP sectors according to the GTAP 10 database. And we have 239 countries in that version, which can be aggregated to 141 GTAP regions. TASTE and create a new version, a lot of steps need to be done. First of all, the MacMap database need to be included. So the MacMap database is provided by the ITC and needs to be included as a text file and with harmonized data into the TASTE program. And an update of the GTAP regions and GTAP sectors for the new version needs to be done. The HS6 and HS4 sector classification need to be changed, and also the original regions need to be adapted. So there needs to be also some classifications for WTO members and non-WTO members, developing and developed countries. And we include also the trade flows of GTAP, because TASE use the trade weights or reference group trade weights for the aggregation procedure. And to make them consistent with the GTAP model, it is necessary to include the GTAP trade flows and scale them to sum to GTAP weights. So it fits perfectly to the GTAP model after the aggregation procedure if the user chooses the scaling. On the following slides, I will show two applications of the TASE program. On this graph, you can see the import tariffs between China and the USA for selected agricultural products. The gray bars show the initial applied tariff rates before the trade conflict for China and for the US. And you can see that for the US, the tariff protection structure is in the initial situation lower than in China, except for sugar. After several tariff increases and also for agricultural products, the following picture can be shown. So for China, they increased tariffs, especially for oil seeds. So this was the soybeans, which were highly addressed also in the media, but also for other products, tariffs were increased. So, and for the US, you can see there are several tariff increases for different products. And even in this example, the tariff increases were decided on the detailed tariff line level. So we can just include the new tariff schedules of the EU and the US into our TASE program and aggregate them to the level of the product groups like wheat, cereals, vegetable fruits, oil seeds, and so on. In our baseline, which we use for our modeling, we include all trade agreements of the EU that were already decided and will be phased in with over the next years. So we look into the tariff schedules and include all the tariff rates which will be reduced within the next years. So, and you can see from these different lines that in some trade agreements, tariffs will be reduced really in the beginning of the agreements, and in some agreements it's more in the end of this agreement. And so to take into account all these different reduction structures, we include that on the tariff line level into our modeling framework. And then we can aggregate that with the help of our TASE program to the model level. For example, if we just look into one specific agreement, this is the agreement between Japan and the EU. Here you can see the initial tariff rates for animal products. And this is a black bar here, and you can see that it is 36% the aggregated tariff for animal products. And then if we look into the tariff reduction schedules and implement all the different tariff cuts into our TASE program, we can see that the tariffs decrease every year until the end of the agreement, the implementation period of the agreement. So this will be 2039. And you can also see that there's a difference between the products which are in terms of ad valorem tariffs, and there are also a lot of quotas included into the agreement between Japan and the EU. And we developed an additional tool to take into account the tariff rate quotas, which will be increased every year during the agreement. So you can see that the light green bar, or the part of the bar which is light green, is the part which is the protection level that comes due to tariff rate quotas. There are many things that you can do with the TASE program, but there are also some limitations. So, for example, it is not possible to do analysis below the HS6 digit tariff line level. This is not possible. And sometimes the tariff schedules are concluded at the 8 or 10 or 12 digit tariff line level. So you have to aggregate them before you can use it in the TASTE program. There is also no facility to create our own formulas. There is no automatic feature that allows tariff reductions that are phased in over time. So you have to run the program every year, and it is not possible to do it in a kind of dynamic setting. And there is no option to change tariff rate quotas or differentiate between specific and ad valorem tariffs. So for the tariff rate quotas that I presented here, we developed an additional MCP model and included the results into the TASTE program afterwards. So the limitations can be addressed by additional programs, which are more complex, but also more flexible. We also have some ideas for future developments of TASTE. One idea is to integrate the tariff reduction schedules, which are available at the ITC website, and to include some scenario files for every user to have a kind of baseline for specific trade agreements. We also would like to integrate some non-tariff barriers or non-tariff measures. It would be nice to differentiate between specific and ad valorem components of tariffs. All the data are available and they are already included in an aggregated form into TASTE, but it would be nice to have them separate. And also to integrate options for tariff rate quotas. Here we have an ad valorem equivalent of the quotas that are already existing in the base data, but for future trade agreements we need to run some model behind to see how the fill rate will be used and to integrate in and out quota tariffs here. And we at the Thünen Institute developed an MCP model which considers tariff rate quotas, and we integrate the results of that MCP model into TASTE. But it would be nice to have an option for every user to differentiate between in and out quota tariffs. So I would like to thank you for your attention. Goodbye.